course, it's $45,000.
Yeah, total.
They win the tournament. They
You're
win.
Right. Yeah, really a lot of mental strength on the Titan side, which is something we're not used to seeing. But I think actually we're already close to being ready with the game here. So it's going to be on Inferno for the second map. And welcome to the show. We've got Titan on the CT side and iBUYPOWER on the Terrorist side. And obviously this is really crucial, because if you lose this, then you're out.
Yeah, simple as that. No lower bracket to fall back on. You lose this, and like Anders said, you're going home. So MBK and Swag, millimeters away from each other. Swag has actually dealt more damage onto MBK. I think it's a battle of two CZ. Smith is gonna come out with the dualies, and he might drop Swag, or is Swag gonna drop him? They're still fighting at each other, Anderson. It seems like no one's gonna die here in Apps.
No, but they got the kill already on Daze, and that's a really good start. MBK, CZ not gonna connect, and he's down to 5 bullets. This is a big problem. He actually can't kill very many people. He's gonna have to one tap away. Of course, Smith has plenty to go around, but he can't really pass them on to MBK, so it doesn't really matter. Bomb goes down, and iBUYPOWER actually have a pretty good chance of doing this, especially with Swag right here in the boiler room waiting. Are they gonna come and check? MBK's gonna charge in, and he goes down, and now it's gonna be Scream fighting it out here. The bomb is ticking away. They have a kit on Scream, so he has to stay alive, and ACK is the only one living in the pit here for iBUYPOWER, but he can cover the bomb from this position. Let's see how it's all gonna unfold. They have to have Scream defusing, and not anyone else. Scream goes down, and yeah, there's gonna be enough time here.
Yeah.
But that's very, very close. One more second, basically, and that could have definitely been around for iBUYPOWER. Titan, though, great hold aggressively up in the apartment, and they're gonna take it.
Yeah, they dealt a lot of damage, particularly MBK, up close and personal in Apps. And Swag's asking for MBK's HP, and MBK's not sure about it. But great pistol round from Titan. And this is the thing about Inferno, even though it's a CT-sided map, most of the time we see the terrorists actually go all in with the Glocks and full armor buy and end up winning it. And they normally give themselves a nice 3-round advantage, but Titan, they'll be over the moon winning this pistol round, in my opinion.
Oh, definitely. They're on the more favored side. They've already won the first map. They have all the momentum in the world. I think more than that, iBUYPOWER are going to be really upset about losing that Dust 2 map. It's going to, I mean, they're professional enough that they can put it behind them and look to win this map. And then talk about professionalism. NBK's picked up an auto shotgun. We've seen him with everything from Sonovs to MP7s to just whatever else he feels like. And this time it's the auto shotgun that comes into play. And I'm actually kind of loving it. This is great.
Goes to show he's, you know, the complete player. He's so versatile, they can use every single weapon in the game.
Yeah, is it going to be put into play? He's trying, and he's going to get the shot down on Swag. So that's just fantastic.
MBK might make it too with the shotgun. He will. Spot skadoodle. Hat trick from MBK.
You've got to be kidding me. Well, the bomb was planted last round, so the Americans can already buy up. But MBK with that 3-0-1 scoreline and 3 of the kills from the auto shotgun means he has 6,000 to work with. He has a lot of money. And we'll have to see what he's going to do. CZ in hand. Is he going to pick up something else? He stays with the shotgun.
With it.
It's not even a bad idea, because the apartments at this A bomb site where he's holding, the shotgun's a perfectly viable weapon, so I'm not even questioning why he's going to do that. Obviously, another quarterfinals we have coming up for you guys later is going to be NIP and Dignitas.
Yep.
And that's obviously going to be a sick match.
Will be. Existence is going to be the man to hold quad. Deals a bit of damage onto Dazed, but they are going to fall back towards second mid. And a really interesting setup from Titan Anders. They've kept 3 players on the B bomb site, but I do think we are going to start seeing Kenny S rotating round back towards the A bomb site now.
And he definitely should. Having 3 early on is kind of a good idea. Having them once you get to the minute mark is not so much a good idea, because then they can kind of hold their own. And really, what Existence is doing there in the beginning,
trying to prevent the push.
Well, and just making sure that he can use the smoke. So he can throw down a smoke. And actually, the fact that he hasn't is a bit concerning, because that means if it was a B push, they'd be running out of smokes really soon.
So Kenny S is going to be the man with the M4. He was holding Arch. He's going back towards the bomb site. Nope, he is going to flash Arch, where iBUYPOWER are actually going to be coming sometime soon. He spots Dave, and all the North Americans are going into that Arch. And it looks like, do you think they're going to wrap around through CT spawn and go to B? But it looks like they're actually going to go to Library, and they are going to commit on this A bomb site. Dazed, 4 angry terrorists are going to push out. Kenny S is going to try and shut Swag down. Does so successfully. The Molotov is going to come out to try and prevent the push round quad. But Kenny S, if you ask me, I was going to say had it under control, but maybe not.
Yeah, now POM goes down in the weird situation when there's still two players inside the pit here. So it's a really strange 4-on-4 with MBK still has the auto shotgun. Smith's going to be coming around the corner here. Skadoodle will take him down, and that's a very, very important kill. That bomb ticked a lot already, and they got to move a lot faster than this Titan. ACK with a sick headshot comes in, and it's going to be Scream Alone 1-on-3, and he should be running away. So this round was a very strange one, because I actually think what iBUYPOWER wanted to do was fake a B push through archway and CT spawn,
yep,
and then have the people on the A bomb side rotate out.
Yeah,
and they could be, yeah, they could catch them rotating. But Titan stayed still, and iBUYPOWER still won the round. So yep, it's a very good sign here. It's going to be 2-1, and the one rifle saved here. It's going to be all right. They can still buy up for Titan.
Yeah, and it's also worth mentioning that in that last round, let's be honest, Titan had a load of farm assets. MBK was stuck with that shotgun, so when they came round from long distance, when the terrorists were actually coming round arch, it was basically MBK doomed in pit with just a shotgun versus AK-47s. And let's be honest, the AK is always going to win that battle.
Yeah, it's not the ideal weapon for long range, there's no doubt about that. Like, medium range, it's still viable, and Mag 7s can even be used at fairly long range sometimes, which is a little bit funny. See, grenade down towards Banana is not going to pick up anyone. There is that one Molotov on steel, which I'm still a big fan of to try and check the corner. I think it's going to be the ninja corner over at Archway, maybe. We'll see what iBUYPOWER come up with. That A push is really good. Can they figure out something similar for B? Then they're really good. I mean, if you can attack both A and B and be successful, generally that's a pretty good sign.
Yeah, well, they've left the bomb at T stats, which is a good decision in my opinion. Obviously, they don't want to lose the bomb so early in the round. Skadoodle, who played very, very well on DDoS 2, it has to be said. He is going to fall back down to the bottom of Banana, and it looks like the North Americans have their heart set on this larger A bomb site yet again. They previously had success there. It's going to be Dazed, the iBUYPOWER leader, to drop Kenny S, and MBK should be able to get a frag or two, or maybe I've jinxed it, maybe not, and it looks like iBUYPOWER know exactly where he is. The nades are going to fly in, Existence is down, and it's only MBK to try and hold this larger A bomb site all by himself now.
Yeah, not going to work out. They know exactly where he is. You're right. And Skadoodle is going to take him down, leaving Smiths and Scream running away. They never even got a chance to rotate fully. So just a very good execution again. iBUYPOWER making it look almost easy to get in and get those kills. And it's in spite of Titan actually trying to catch them out. They had a flash into the middle Titan, and Dazed picked up the first kill. So it's a very good job. Now, it's just going to be 2-2, and we're moving straight into the fifth round, of course, where we have to worry about Titan, because they are running out of money at this point, and saving these two rifles is good, but I'm not sure it's quite good enough.
Well, as a famous supermarket once said, every little helps, and it's better than nothing. And
yeah,
right decision in the end made by Titan, and it is going to see the game go even Steven at 2-2.
They can buy up on MBK, he will buy up, and the rest, are they going to buy armor and pistols here? So Titan are having a couple of force rounds here. And I think what we've learned earlier in this tournament is that if you have the situation and you keep forcing it up,
yeah,
if you eventually win, it's kind of all right. But if you end up losing so much that you're actually forced to eco, then all you've done is waste rounds and you're going to be ecoing anyway. And that's tricky.
And there are a lot of teams who would rather, you know, just play it out and try go for a full eco and then buy in the next round. But Titan, they feel confident, of course. They are 1-0 up, as it says at the bottom of your screens, guys. So we've got Scream. In fact, is that three players? Yeah, three Titan players are holding this B bombsite yet again. And Anders, they did it before. They're doing it again. Tell us why they're doing it.
Well, the weird thing is, I'm just going to say the reason you normally do this is because one of the three would put down a smoke. But actually what you can see is that Kenny, who was just here, he's only just used his smoke now. And that's all the way over at library. So they've still got two smokes in this bomb site, which is, oh, there we go. Okay, so actually Kenny smoked it off all the way from Archway. So they use that smoke anyway. And Smiths, is he going to go for another one here? I think that smoke's going to land over where Scream is. So they're smoking off that B bomb site quite heavily. Smith is going to come out of library and goes down to Swag. It's going to be another A push, and it's working so far, but not now. NBK picks up a quick double kill. Dazed and ACK goes down, and in the middle, they're going to drop Skadoodle as well. So very, very aggressive play coming out from Titan. They're not leaving a lot of room for iBUYPOWER to work with here.
Yeah, NBK with three kills makes it four before falling to his death. And now 3 versus 1, it's Steel, last man standing. He has the AK. Steel drops true, and he looks like he is gonna stampede his way over to the B bomb site. And I think Existence knows exactly where he's going. And now it's basically a race, Anders. Can Steel get that bomb down, or is Existence gonna get there in time to stop him? And you know what? He won't. 4 seconds on the clock, and the bomb is down.
Oh man, that was an absolutely great double kill coming out from Steel there. That that mow down worked just so well, and now he's hiding in a really good position. And you have to consider, Existence has so many corners to check, so we'll see. He's walking in, Steel's already spotted him, he's gonna flash out. I think he saw him as well. So one flash, two flash, now he's gonna try and take the peek here. A lot of time already wasted. Existence has to move quick right now. Steel is gonna go down, and there's gonna be just enough time to get the defuse as well, so almost worked. That was almost going to be a 1-on-3 win for Steel, but doesn't come out that way. Titan end up spending a lot of money this round, and I think iBUYPOWER, I mean, with the bomb plant as well, they're going to be able to buy.
Yep, they will be able to buy. Titan, they'll be over the moon with that round, especially when you consider it was 3 versus 1. I looked at it and I thought, nah, Titan aren't going to throw this one. But Steel, ever since iBUYPOWER, ever since he made the move back to North America, he's entered this iBUYPOWER roster, and I have to be fully honest, I do think he's one of their star players.
Yeah, he's a very, very solid player. There's no doubt about that. And maybe, I mean, maybe he could have won that 1-on-1 at the end. That would have been really impressive. That would have even forced Titan to eco, so it would have been much worse. So actually, the force up that they did now, talking about it, because I did point out, now it's worth it. And this is obviously a big gamble. We saw it end up in a 1-on-1, but it turns out to be worth it at the end.
It's also worth mentioning that MBK when got the quad kill with his M4. And when you've got a player of MBK's quality on your side who can just, in one round, get 4 kills just like that out of 5 opponents, then obviously it makes your life a lot easier as one of his teammates. Especially when force buying.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, that saved the round ultimately. Yeah. That was obviously what set it all up. Right now, a very standard push coming out towards Archway here from iBUYPOWER. I don't think they're really committing to anything. You can see the bomb being dropped all the way back. They just really want the pick off on somebody. And Kenny, going to be the choice of the target of choice here. Going to be going down, Zuzka Doodle. Existence trying to flash himself in with that pop flash. Going to take a quick peek, not really spotting anyone. But already in library, there's a guy holding in. Existence seems like he's not really aware that Dazed made it by, so that makes it all the more effective. ACK gets a kill. Existence going to get backstabbed by Dazed. She's sneaking on through. Very, very cheeky play coming out, and it's going to be Smiths and Scream left. 2-on-4. Bomb will go down, and they should definitely run away.
Yep, they should, and it looks like they are going to. They're going to save those 2M4s, and again, I can't blame them. And Anders, we're 6 rounds in, and it's going to end up being 3-3. I mean, the way it's going, iBUYPOWER, surely they're on course for more than 5 rounds as terrorists.
I definitely think so. The way that Titan have been holding this A bomb site has not proven very effective, and it's really hard even to explain why that is. It feels like, actually, the way that things are going down in that A bomb site is that Titan end up retreating so far back in that by the time the engagement happens, they're being attacked from Archway, from Quad,
so
and sometimes from apartments as well. Yeah, so they're covering all the angles at the same time. And even worse still, if there's smoke going off towards Pit, it means they don't even have everyone covering everywhere.
Yeah.
So it becomes a little bit too tricky. I'm actually thinking they should try and go more aggressively.
Yeah, I was going to say that. You know, but push through apps, maybe.
Yeah, iBUYPOWER have made that really hard as well, because if you try and do it towards Archway, they keep molotoving that one corner. So how are you going to stay there? You kind of have to go further back. It's actually just it's sort of a little bit of subtle pressure being put on here by iBUYPOWER. I think that's what's making a big difference.
So Skadoodle has the big green gun in the AWP, and he's all eyes on mid. Dazed is in second mid alongside his right hand man in Steel. Steel is going to get the first frag onto Kenny S, and Scream, of course, still has that M4, which he salvaged from the last round. MBK gets the CZ frag. Scream gets an M4 frag. He might be able to make it 2 in a row. Existence will with the USB headshot. And wow, iBUYPOWER are falling and dropping like flies. And this could end up being a brilliant eco round from the French-Belgium team.
Yeah, checking in the background here. Smith's going to come up looking for the kill. He's maybe going to get it. He will take it down. Skadoodle drops it out. ACK in a 1-on-4. Going to get the return, but probably not enough. If he could get the bomb plant down, he'd be in a better position, but they're all around him. And he's going to fake it once, takes down MBK. This is definitely not over yet. It's a 2-on-1. ACK goes for another fake. He has time for it here, but they are closing in on him, and he needs to win this round for his team. This would be a big upset for iBUYPOWER if they lost an eco round or an anti-eco.
It would be. But AZK knows with 20 seconds to go, he has to commit to this bomb plant, but doesn't want to. As of yet, Scream knows it's yet another fake. And now, and AZK has no choice, he has to plant. Existence is slowly going to walk in. I'm actually quite surprised they let him plant. But here we go, AZK versus Existence. He was on, the 4v1 was almost on the cards. But Scream somehow salvages something out of that round for Titan, and they will retake the lead at 4-3.
If he somehow had managed to actually get that spray home on the last player, that would have been gruesome, but it doesn't work out that way, and Titan win an eco round, and they're going to be ecstatic about that, because right now the score is not looking too comfortable for them. 4-3 here, and iBUYPOWER can still buy it. Are they going to pick up the AWP on Skadoodle, I'm wondering? No, he's going to go for the AK instead. So fair enough, they designed it. No, sorry, someone else bought it for him. So there we are. Skadoodle. Picking one up.
Saw what he could do with it on DDoS 2. Fingers crossed he can do the exact same thing here on Inferno. But Titan, no one's going to really come his way at mid. Kenny S is opposing AWPer, has decided to go towards Banana. No surprise there.
Yeah, he picked up the kill on ACK, so that's a really good opening. And Kenny with the AWP on Inferno is actually really good because it takes a bit of a special kind of AWPer to AWP on a map which is this close quarters, and there are a couple of them out there, but some AWPers don't do all that well on this map, and they tend not to use the AWP when it comes to it.
Yeah,
so
yeah, it's not rare to see all full rifle setups on terrorist side of on the terrorist side of Nuke for many teams out there, which is understandable.
It's going to be a flash that's going into B, and actually iBUYPOWER have decided the A bomb site's no longer as attractive. They want to go for V, and it's a really good choice this time. Scream is the only one defending. Backup is coming quick. They're going to get the bomb down immediately. Smoked off right at the front of the bomb site. Very intelligent play. Something we've seen Fnatic popularize for a while now, and it's working out for iBUYPOWER too. It's going to be a 4-on-5 here, and the bomb is... This is going to be a very tough retake for a Titan. I really think they need to think hard about this.
Yeah, especially with Skadoodle on fire. Two kills from him. Scream is going to try and salvage something. He can hear where Steel is. It's Scream, last man standing with that unsilenced M4. Scream with the double, but the bomb is ticking. And I don't think he'll be able to get it. He definitely won't be able to get it after Steel nails him in the head. And 4-4 on Anders. Every time it seems like Titan win a round, iBUYPOWER are just one step ahead of him again and answer back by winning their own round.
And in the long run, especially being on the terrorist side, that's going to come up hugely in favor of the American team. And actually, we see already that Titan really don't have the money to buy. So it's going to be another eco, and this could be iBUYPOWER taking the round lead here on the less favored side. Again, this is not looking good.
Unfortunately not for Titan fans out there. Scream is chilling in spawn at the moment. Skadoodle still open down mid. He's sort of waiting to see if any of these Titan players will push, but I don't think they want to give him that satisfaction. I think Titan know that he's going to be waiting at T-steps at mid. Because on DDoS 2, you said that DayZ is one of those leaders who does his homework all the time, but so is Existence, and he'll definitely know that Skadoodle will be at T-steps trying to get an AWP frag. MBK gets one. He might be able to get two, but he is on his last breath on only 18 points of health, and Swag, despite dropping Kenny S, it's going to be MBK to get the return kill.
I still look at even a pick up one here, but it's a 4-on-3, and if Titan steals yet another eco round, then iBUYPOWER really needs to go back and try and see if they can work on how not to lose anti-ecos, because that is... That's too painful at this point. They really can't do it any longer. I mean, mentally, it takes away from you as well. You start feeling like, okay, we could be at a scoreline that says maybe 6-2 instead of 4-4 if we actually just win these rounds.
That's the thing, because you lose one round, it might force you to eco the next round, and you technically should lose that as well. And before
Look
you know it,
Scream.
Like you said, the difference. But see, you're right, Scream is playing in this ninja. He's surrounded by angry Titan players. Scream pushes him. Scream pulls the trigger. Scream gets the double with the CZ. And Titan are back in the lead. And how many times have I said that so far this game?
What's interesting is that Scream didn't even really need that position. He could have just waited on the bottom. Obviously, you know, that's just like a coincidence. So iBUYPOWER actually just messed up a little bit in not checking. So that's unfortunate.
Was 5-4 in favor of Titan. And iBUYPOWER, Anders, they can still afford time. But AZK seems to be CZ-ing it.
Well, that's a big strength, I think, so far for the terrorist side here, is just that they keep on being able to purchase rifles. And Titan obviously could take a really big leap forward in winning this round and forcing them to really eco. And then hopefully they won't be throwing away any eco rounds themselves or anti-ecos. It's going to be a push up second mid for the Terrorist side, just trying to take a little bit of control here. But they're playing this one kind of slowly.
Yeah, they are. And one thing I noticed about iBUYPOWER when looking into them, they do like a slow, methodical setup. And this is the thing, it depends on the players in your team. And also, something we were speaking about to Thorin yesterday, was it also depends on where you're from. For example, East European teams often like to play a more offensive brand of Counter-Strike. But Kenny, yes, we saw him miss these shots on Didos too. And it really does look baffling from the GoTV point of view, because on my end, it looked like the crosshair was on him. But he has missed the shot. Existence spots a few coming around quad and Skadoodle, brilliant shot. And Titan are one man down.
And even, yeah, this is a big problem. Even worse, this MBK is the only one down here in the pit. Everyone else was over at the B bomb site, and it's going to be a good shot onto ACK, but this bomb is going to go down. And MBK, I think he's on a really short leash here. He's going to get another kill in, which is quite impressive. Swag goes down. Now MBK has to look up towards that graveyard, otherwise he could end up getting taken out. Dazed is going to fall next. iBUYPOWER, for once, having a really hard time actually holding this bomb site. It's Steel and Skadoodle left 2-on-4 right now. It's going to be a Molotov. No, Steel can't get it off. Skadoodle in the corner in a 1-on-4, and so much time has ticked, but they are going to be able to find that bomb. And it's going to be just in time as well. So there it is, Titan retaking the bomb site, and NBK triple kill and staying alive for the whole duration of that siege. That was very impressive.
In my opinion, he's definitely been their standout player so far on Inferno on this CT side. Yeah. And let's be fully honest, he got a 4-1 with the AWP on Didos 2 as well. So he's definitely stepped his game up in comparison to what we saw on Mirage. And again, we know it's what he can do. Titan, in the last few weeks, they've been sort of that on-off team, where they can end up losing a game that they should have blatantly won and then end up pulling off a comeback against NIP on Nuke. So it's good to see that they're starting to find their feet, they're starting to find their form, and what better way to reintroduce themselves back into, you know, into the set of top teams, because a lot of people are doubting them, by beating what a way to introduce themselves into it by beating iBUYPOWER and sending themselves to the semi-finals.
Oh man. This is turning into a really close game once again. I mean, 6-4 all of a sudden is looking a lot better. And iBUYPOWER, they got the bomb down. It's actually one of the reasons why they forced it up once again. So they're in that same pattern that Titan were in earlier, where every round they have to make a choice. Are we going to eco once, or are we going to force up once again?
Existence and MBK. It's going to be Existence in pit. And MBK on top of that balcony. Dazed is there, MBK definitely heard him, fires off a few shots, and Dazed is gonna fall back. And we see AZK with the bomb, and Skadoodle slowly making their way around Arch, and Kenny S is waiting for them at Library. Do you think they're gonna commit to A, or do you think they're gonna try and go CT spawn towards B?
It looks like an A push right now, which Titan should absolutely be able to deal with. I'm going to be surprised if they can't here. Kenny will miss a shot, but they still have three people holding this bomb site. It should definitely not be a big problem. Skadoodle is going to take down MBK. Existence in the pit. Great shot, Skadoodle. Are you joking now? It's just Kenny defending, and he's not realizing ACK's in this corner. ACK comes charging in, takes down Kenny, and it's a 2-on-2. That bomb has gone down. And ACK has to stay alive for a little bit longer. He's going to quick peek Mr. Smith, and now the shot's raining through. He knows that he's there. And over at the quad side, it's going to be Scream sneaking up right underneath Skadoodle.
It will be, and Skadoodle, I think, knows where he is, and ACK knows exactly where Smith is as well. It's Galil versus M4, and the French-Belgium M4 wins, and it's 1 versus 1. The bomb is ticking. Smith knows he has to hold on to this defuse. He's not going to hold on to it. He will get the kill, but he's also going to run away because Anders, he has no time to defuse.
No, he's going to go up with the bomb as well. I think dies in the CT spawn where he started. That is a really, really impressive round from Skadoodle. Those two opening kills definitely should not have happened, but the fact that they did, and then they managed to get the bomb down as well. Skadoodle just carrying again. I mean, and Dust2, he dropped 30 kills, and iBUYPOWER couldn't win the round or win the game, but this time he's got 10, so has ACK, and it's 6-5, and Titan can, they can sneak in a buy here, but they're again very close to ecoing. This game is getting scary once again. This is so close all the time, and iBUYPOWER are not letting go.
They're not. Kenny S with that big green gun, or the big white and orange gun in his case, drops AZK. And again, Kenny S, those entry frags are so crucial for Titan.
They definitely are. Existence does almost go down in return. And MBK also dropping a little bit low. We'll have to find out here, moving into the 12th round, exactly how this is going to unfold for iBUYPOWER with Three AK stories, one Galil on the team, and a couple of smokes still left. And again, they want to go for the A-bomb site because it's been working so well for them.
Smith is going to push around. Quad Scream is hiding in Arch as the North Americans try to wrap around this larger A-bomb site. Steel gets one. He will get shut down by Existence, leaving it 4-1. And well, MBK coming around the back. He won't miss from there. 7-5.
A very interesting round. Swag down in the boiler room actually looked like he was going to be able to pick up a couple of kills on some Titan members, but this time it was very different, and maybe a sigh of relief coming out here from Titan because they needed that round. Otherwise, they were going to be ecoing in, and now iBUYPOWER have no choice. This is a really hard eco coming out. They're down to 1,400, and at this point, we could almost see them go for a double eco and try and just win the sixth round, or the 15th round in that case. Because they really don't have any money to work with at all right now.
Well, this is the thing. When you're on the terrorist side of Inferno, in an ideal world, obviously, you'd want 15. Everyone would like 15. But 5 is a very good amount of rounds for iBUYPOWER now. And even if they end up losing this half 10-5, I don't think they'd give a damn at all. They'd be over the moon with 5 rounds against Titan. But you're right.
Well, it kind of depends on how strong they are mentally. Because 5 rounds is enough for them to work with, I think. But I think the problem is, iBUYPOWER could have had 8 rounds at this point. They've lost so many anti-ecos.
Yeah.
This could have been a completely different game.
Yeah.
So I think if they worry too much about that aspect and really get annoyed at themselves, 5 rounds is scary still.
But say so.
Oh, Swag here, going to go in down to 13 HP. Kenny looking for another one. It's going to give the shot. It's actually a double shot, and now the pistol's out. Kenny with the one, with the two. That's going to be a triple. Eventually, they bring down the Titan, but it's going to be Skadoodle and ACK left now. 2-on-4 here, and we'll see if they can get anything done.
Yep, ACK is going to be sat in library with that beautiful orb, Asimov. Skadoodle, his right-hand man. And we have 2 CTs on the B-bomb site and 2 CTs on the A-bomb site, and you know, just splitting it up, standard stuff from Titan, but it does look like they are going to commit towards the smaller B-bomb site. Skadoodle runs past Scream, and this last kill should really be easy peasy for Scream. And there we go. Crisp headshot from the headshot master.
And
I thought we were going to see a get right high five fail there, but fortunately Titan, MBK gave it back to him.
Was there a get right high five fail?
Have you not seen it on YouTube?
No, the one I remember is the one from Idra. From StarCraft, there's the one where I think
I'll
it's Artosis. That's a very funny one. I really enjoyed that. Kenny, AWP in hand. We're moving into the 14th round, and iBUYPOWER, no double eco. But as a result, you can see it's going to be Galil's 1 AK and smokes they have, but they really don't have a lot of grenades here. So iBUYPOWER decide this is basically a choice between playing between 9-6 or 8-7. And iBUYPOWER feel like we can hit for 8-7 here. We're going to go for it.
Yeah. Why not? Why not? They've got...
Well, the problem is you can end up ending at 10-5 instead. So it's not just the choice between those two. There's a third option, which is the really bad one where Titan win this round. So we'll see Kenny with a really aggressive flick going to go up and take down ACK. Now they're charging him down, and he survives on actually still a lot of health. He actually just makes it out of those apartments. That's really impressive.
It isn't. He's quickly to change his position. He knows he was last spotted in apartments. He knows that iBUYPOWER probably going to be trying to hunt him down, so he's gone back to territory he's familiar with on Archside, and it looks like he might have Dazed coming his way.
Yeah, good grenade from Kenny. Smoke is obviously going to keep him out of the fray for a little bit, but how much longer? If they push around here, he's definitely ready for an Existence down in the bomb site. Kenny's going to pick up Dazed, and now this attack is not working out well at all for iBUYPOWER. It's going to be Kenny now with a triple, and it's going to be Existence with one of them. NBK picks up a kill, and we're looking at a 9-5, and again, absolutely no money. So the gamble, this time it does not work out, and this could really come back to bite them now. Instead of 8-7 or 9-6, we're looking at a 10-5 scoreline, and I think you're right, though. 5 rounds can definitely be enough when you're on the T side.
Yeah.
But I think mentally right now, iBUYPOWER in a very bad spot.
Okay.
So actually, your 2-0 prediction for Titan can end up being true here.
Yeah. Well, there's only one way to find out. Let's wait and see. Titan yet again sending 3 players towards Banana, throwing those nades down, but unfortunately not dealing too much damage. But it's understandable why they did that, to prevent the B push, because they know that iBUYPOWER will be eco in this round.
Carpet bombing the Banana area is a good idea. Aggressive push coming out from iBUYPOWER here in the last round of this first half of the map. And it's not working out. MBK hitting nothing but headshots. Existence shooting him a little bit just to keep him fired up. And in the corner, he might actually get overrun here. Kenny throwing up a Molotov to try and deny that bomb plant, but it will be going down in a 3-on-3 retake coming out from Titan.
Yep, here comes Kenny around quad side. He's all eyes on Pit, spotted dazed, and now the smoke is going to come out, and hopefully he'll definitely have called that to his teammates, but he is hanging onto a thread. He's only got 29 points of health. Smiths is going to drop AZK with that M4 shot to the face, and now 3 versus 2. You'd really expect Titan to utilize the fact that they were one man up. They still are one man up, thanks to Scream. It's Daze who's hiding in Pit. He knows exactly where the bomb has been planted. The defuse is coming in from Scream, and he's holding onto it, and Daze, oh, the defuse comes in.
Oh, and
milliseconds.
You can see the reaction from Dazed. I don't want to try and translate the words that were coming out of his mouth then, but that was not a happy situation for iBUYPOWER.
I love how they just zoomed in on his face there.
Yeah, well, 10-5 for the first half, and to be honest, this could have been 10-5 in favor of iBUYPOWER instead. So I think in that context, and that's why I said this is the big difference, that's why I think they're not happy about the situation, is because they could have had so much more in this game.
Could have done
way, way more than they did. But for Titan, they are just 6 rounds away, Kainite, from being able to pick up the actual game here and move on to the semis.
But one thing that Sliggy, our spectator, was pointing out was that Scream was actually left with only 1 point of health on that defuse.
Are you joking?
No, it was. But it's obviously gone now, but I'm sure the people on the stream will have definitely seen it.
What an upset. Well, We're seeing everything here at the Gfinity tournament. It's been a real pleasure. So once again, thanks for joining us. Second half is coming up here. It's the second map quarterfinals between Titan and iBUYPOWER. With Titan already taking the first map on Dust 2 in a most incredible comeback. And now they are off to a really good start here. In spite of everything that iBUYPOWER has been throwing at them, somehow Titan has come out on top, and we'll see if they can win this pistol round 2. If they can, I don't see them losing the map any longer. If iBUYPOWER win it, there's no reasons why the American team cannot push us on to a third map. We'll have to find out. Right now, they're going for a bit of a dangerous stack, having just stolen this bomb site with a P2000 and looking to see if we can take a shot on anyone coming in. But Titan are just trying to fake it out, running back and forth as they please.
Yep, and see, they first went towards the A bomb site, made a bit of noise there. Then they fell back to Banana, made a bit of noise there. Now it looks like they are going to go towards this A bomb site. Data's gone very aggressive. Skadoodle has got a double before being shut down by Kenny S. And now 3 versus 3. Swag is going to try and hold it from Apartments. And this is going back to what we were talking about earlier. But hold on a second. Skadoodle with yet another USP here, headshot. And he has a hat trick so far, Anders.
I've never really been any doubt about how good Skadoodle is, but he's definitely hitting a personal level or personal high right here. This is very, very cool to be witnessing. Unfortunately, the Belgian leader here, really tricky play, puts the bomb down in B, and the problem is now Swag is miles away. Steel has a kit, and that's very important. And this grenade actually from Steel can end Kenny. If he throws it into the corner, that's all he needs to do, and it's going to be all right. So we'll have to see if Steel is going to be up to it. They have the 2-on-1. And I really want to see this from Steel's point of view for a second, just to see if he's going to be able to put down that grenade. But they're just going to try and check everywhere. Swag goes down, and now the grenade comes out. Kenny in the corner, he survives. It does no damage, and Kenny, he's going to go down. But Steel, he had to spend too much time doing that. I'm not sure he's going to get it. I think Titan, they get it in the last second. Are you joking? Oh, what a relief from iBUYPOWER. That is a huge round for them. I thought the fact that he had to go and throw that grenade would have been just enough for them to lose the round. And you can see even Steel wasn't entirely sure.
Yeah.
And it did no damage. What a round. And Existence picks up an AK. So the bomb plant means, and the kills decide, all right, we're going to go for armor on 3, AK on 1, CZ 75s and armor on the rest except for Kenny. Interesting.
Yeah, they want to force it. They want to try and keep iBUYPOWER stuck on 6 and only 6 rounds. We have Steel and Dazed playing the B bomb site, and Titan are all on Banana.
This could catch them off guard. I mean, this FAMAS is not as effective against what's coming. It's an AK, and Dazed running away, calling out what's happening over at the B bomb site, but Steel is there to back him up. Gonna take down Smith, looking for another shot here. Steel in the back has to reload really quick, and they're low on health as well. Steel goes down, Dazed goes down, and it's a 3-on-4. They're picking up the rifles that have fallen. The bomb is gonna go down, and this is a great round from Titan. Instantly bouncing back, not giving iBUYPOWER any room to get back into this game, and this retake is severely handicapped. This is not going to be easy. Skadoodle only has a pistol as well. He's saving for it all, but that's not the time to do it. Scream goes down. Kenny with the headshot on Skadoodle, and this is all in or nothing here. iBUYPOWER have to retake this round. It's a one-on-one. Swag hits a great headshot and gets a double. He's going to try for the defuse once here, but Existence is waiting. Absolutely smart play. Goes for the grenade once. Swag is running out of time, and Titan are going to win. One AK is all it took, and they take the round away.
And it's no surprise that we've started seeing teams try to employ that sort of strategy after using the pistol round. It's not just Titan. I think we may have seen it from Dignitas yesterday. I'm not 100% sure which team it was, but it's definitely something not that we've just seen here at G3, but it's something that we've been seeing online as well. It's I don't know who invented it or who came up with the idea, but it just goes to show that surprises sometimes can win you rounds in Counter-Strike.
Yeah, I really don't know. It looked like iBUYPOWER, especially because they saw the AK and managed to fall back. It seemed like they should have had a little bit of time to react. But Titan just got those kills in and only lost the one player going into the bomb site. It's just a lot of things working for the Titan team here. And here we go with the Shawnoff shotgun on MBK, and he's pushing in first. He's looking for those kills. And it's actually pretty powerful now because it can shoot through a lot more surfaces than it could before. He's going to pick up the one kill, goes down, and then Dazed burns to death. Scream with another headshot comes in, takes down Skadoodle, and the B-bomb site's cleared in the middle. They have Smith just going down. I was going to say take, you know, covering the flank, but that's not quite true.
There we go. They picked up that AK-47, and they are actually going to take on Titan 2 versus 3. Kenny S somehow manages to flash himself, but he is going to hide in this corner and try to stop the incoming North Americans. And so far, he's done a good job of it. And AZK, to no surprise, Anders, he's just going to fall back and save the AK.
That is a good choice. No doubt about that. 12-6 scoreline. And how much money have they got on iBUYPOWER's side? That's a big question here. So they actually don't have that much. But I, with saving this AK, I wouldn't be surprised if they're going to try and force it up. That's been the name of the game so far anyway. So they might as well keep doing it. But it really won't be an impressive buy. I think it's going to be really tricky.
Not able to do enough damage to get the kill in the end there.
So one M4, maybe another one on ATK if it's an M4A1 and then two for Masters. I think they're going to go for it, but they won't. They are actually going to save once more.
They are. I guess AZK and co. wanting to take a leaf out of the Titan book with that, you know, one AK setup. Ask the rest of them are going to go for the CZ-75s. I think the main difference here is that when Titan did it, they went for armor because they got the bomb down. They had that small cash injection. In this case, iBUYPOWER, they haven't risked as much money into this round on the CT side as in comparison to what Titan did.
For once, I actually think iBUYPOWER should have forced up that round. I would have gone for it. Because at 13-6, the other team is more than doubling your round score, and you can't make any single mistake. And also because right now, Titan, you know, if they come out of this round with a bunch of people alive, their economy is going to be looking that much stronger. So we'll have to see. They do have a really good stack here at the B-bomb site, and a great position from Steel looking over that one. So we'll see if they can make something work. ACK up by the coils, and so far he's not been smoked off, but wouldn't be surprised if somebody's going, oh, Steel. Somehow that Molotov just disappears. What just happened? Now ACK pushes in, and if he gets a headshot, it's going to be golden, but he's missing a couple here. He's going to go down. Scream with a quick double, and Steel has been found out as well. They've discovered him in the corner, and he's going to go down. Steel next. Kenny going to pick off Swag, and Skadoodle comes in. I'm not sure where that Molotov went.
No, because on our screens, it looked like it was exactly on Steel, but then it's almost as if some sort of Molotov destroyer, or as if he had a fire extinguisher on him. Skadoodle has gotten two, and do you think he'll go for this, or do you think he'll save? It looks like he is going to save a right or wrong decision.
Yeah, definitely right, especially because we know they're going to be buying the next round. But yeah, well, he goes down, which is a great shot coming up from Kenny and a great double, but obviously they can still buy. That's the whole point of what iBUYPOWER has been doing here. So they're going to be fully equipped.
Yeah.
And now they need to have an absolutely insane second half here. Like, from here on out, all mistakes have to go right out the window. iBUYPOWER have to play a perfect second half right now.
Yeah, you can argue it's do or die for iBUYPOWER now. They lose this round, Titan find themselves on 14, only two rounds away from actually winning the game. And there you go, they smoke the bottom of Banana. And we see the two Titan players actually go really aggressive at Carr, trying to constrict the breathing space that Titan are being given.
Aggressive push up from Titan, really putting a lot of pressure here on the CT side. And they do have three people in this bomb side holding. But once again, this is actually what we were talking about when Titan were on the CT side. They're pushed very far back into the bomb site. So if it goes wrong, if they don't get the entry frags, that's not going to be good. iBUYPOWER though, Skadoodle will pick up that first one. They're shooting right through. But this is a very, very important kill. Because again, if you get pushed too far back in, that's a problem.
It is. So, four versus three. Four AK-47s versus three M4s and an AWP. So, here goes nothing. Titan look like they are going to fall back down towards the bottom of mid, and they are going to dedicate over to this B-bomb site where Anders, only Steel is on top of this B-bomb site.
Steel has one smoke, but because the position he's in, if they decide to push through, I mean, he's going to have to land some great headshots. I love the fact that Daze is going to come back right here. Really, really good timing from iBUYPOWER and a good read from them here. Smoke is going to go off here, but let's see if they can't manage to crossfire their way through. No shots being hit just yet, and Steel in the background is going to have to come up really big. He misses the first one, and now backup has to be called for quick. Daze goes down. If they kill Steel, that just might be it, and they will. Now it's a 3-on-3, but the bomb is going to go down, and all of a sudden, the retake is very, very tough here. iBUYPOWER have no grenades to try and flash their way in or anything like that.
Here we go. Skadoodle is going to make his way around the back of ruins. AZK is going to make Skadoodle's job a little bit easier with that M4 frag, but Scream is going to nail Skadoodle in the head, leaving it 2 versus 2. MBK is hiding at the back of the bombsite. He's only on 20 points of health, and Scream is low as well. Scream misses the shot. MBK being chased down, and surely the defuse will come in. Yes, it will. They have kits. And I honestly thought it was that was it when Titan got in on the bombsite. When they planted, they were out. They outnumbered iBUYPOWER. But what a great retake.
Yeah, I agree. Definitely looked like it was going to be the terrorist side winning that one round, but they don't. The bomb goes down, so they can actually still buy up here. They can just spread around some AKs, and I think that's what they're going to do as well. 13-7, and iBUYPOWER winning a round that they could not afford to lose anyway. They had been ecoing specifically to win that one round, so if they lost that, I think all hope would have gone out the window for the North American team. But now they're still in it. It's a 6-round difference, and they have to keep fighting.
Do and Titan are trying that interesting boost to try and get a bit of information over that smoke. But that's the thing you said yesterday, because we're starting to see so many teams try and do it, it's becoming a bit predictable.
Skadoodle jumping, that's actually very smart, because very little chance. Now he's going to take the peak quicks, can't spot anyone. They also did give it up down there. And a much slower round from Titan than the one they did last time.
Slower and methodical, a bit similar to iBUYPOWER's playing style when they were on the T side. But here we go, Kenny S is going to run straight through that smoke. Alongside him is his leader in existence, and it's going to be existence to get the first Titan frag. Smith joins in on the action while Swag is playing it. Ninja in pit, he drops one, he drops two, leaving it 2 versus 2. And Swag, I thought he was going to make it 3, but just maybe not yet. He needs to reload.
Oh, he's so low on health, and in this pit is not a good position any longer. He could have got a couple of kills, and I actually think that was the silencer working out. Existence makes the jump, and he's going to run for the B-bomb side. Exactly the right move, and Swag has to do something. And when he does, NBK is there to pick up the double, and we're looking at a 14-7 scoreline with no money for iBUYPOWER. The worst possible scenario, they win the round, then they lose the next one. That resets their round loss bonus and puts them in a very deep hole right now. I think Titan, they may have just done this.
Yeah. Well, I predicted 2-0, just saying.
Yeah, you did. It was a good prediction. Based on the maps as well, it was definitely not unlikely that this would happen. But I think more than anything, what we've seen here so far today is that Titan, again, mentally have improved massively. And this is the first tournament in a while where we can really say Titan have played up to their name almost. Yeah. And it's really nice to see. So we'll have to find out. iBUYPOWER, well, we'll have to see. They're obviously not out yet, but things are looking really grim at the moment.
Here we go, MBK is going to push Steel, drops him, knows that Daze is to his right as well, spraying and praying, but Daze goes big with the double CZ kill, and Anders, you're shaking your head.
Yeah, that was really cool, Daze. He saved a couple of bullets for that next headshot. That was nicely played. If it's going to be enough is a different question. Good little pickup there by Swag, taking that AK, and we're in a 2-on-3. Still plenty of time for Titan to make something work, and whatever bombsite they go through, this is basically a 3-on-1 for the one player that's in the bombsite, and it's going to be down to Swag, and unfortunately, he hasn't had the best game of his life so far. Actually, feels like he's been a little bit pressured this land, so I'm not sure if it's the traveling or whatever it is, but definitely not the swag we're used to seeing. So we'll have to find out if now is going to be the time for the young talent to step it up. He's in the back here behind the new boxes. He's hearing them coming in, and backup is coming. He's trying to creep around. Really good movement, but he's going to go down. Could have been an excellent double spray down, but Scream is going to drop him. And ACK, I think we're looking at match and map point here. ACK is going to pick up the kill. He has got a kit, but this one on two is going to be tricky.
It is. He's got Kenny S to his right, and he's got Scream to his left. That's going to be a great nade. AZK blows Kenny S away. AZK with the clutch, and the Americans, well, the North Americans, are still fighting back, Anders.
Man, if this is the round to spark the comeback, that's going to be insane. That grenade, for once it did damage. The last time it didn't do anything, but this time it was absolutely fantastic. So, and now Titan, actually, in spite of the bomb plant, won't have quite enough money, so maybe going to be a bit of a free round coming in from iBUYPOWER. Big question is, can they win the next 8 rounds in a row flawlessly? Yeah, mathematically speaking, they definitely can, but it's been proven rough. I mean, it's been a hard-fought battle so far.
It has, and they've gone for that strange force buy where they force only one guy to buy the AK-47 again, Anders.
It worked the last time, maybe it'll work again.
Yeah.
Skadoodle's got to be careful MBK doesn't somehow creep up and jump on him, because he actually hasn't got any backup. Scream will take down ACK. Don't let it end like this. That would be the saddest thing ever. Skadoodle goes down. The force buy from Titan is working currently. NBK is going to charge in. It will take down Steel as well through the fire. Almost. He's on 1 HP. Almost burned to death. And Dace can't find the crossover shot here. It's going to be a 2-on-5. And Titan, almost a humiliating round coming out so far here for iBUYPOWER.
Yeah, well, you called it. You said it was humiliating. But, you know, we saw ADK pull the clutch off of last round. Maybe, just maybe, this 5v2 might become a reality. But Kenny S drops Days. Swag gets the double. We said that we haven't seen really Swag play at his best. And maybe he's not at his best just yet, because I think the Swag of a few months ago may have at least got 3 kills there. It's disappointing.
There's something a little bit off, and you know, everyone can have a bad day. The problem is, today is not a good time to have a bad day, because it's playoff days. It's going to end today. It's the grand finals that's going to be happening, so you want to be your absolute best. Titan, match and map point. They are only one round away from actually 2-0-ing iBUYPOWER here in the tournament, and it's not been easy. iBUYPOWER was seconds away from winning on Dust 2, and they could have had a 10-5 first half on this map. I think there's going to be a lot of stuff to go when they get back to the practice, or practicing back home to America.
Here we go. Swag is going to open things up with that first CZ-75 kill onto Smiths. And of course, this is the worrying thing when you are on the T side and you have those AK-47s and you're playing against CTs who are ecoing. You die, you literally hand over your AK-47 to them.
Yeah. Which is good news. Swag has body armor as well, so there's something to work with. And Kenny's going to pick up the return frag on ACK. And Titan, they haven't won yet. 7 rounds for iBUYPOWER, and we're looking at overtime. So that can also still happen. Skadoodle with the shotgun, and Steel is the... No, who's... Yeah, it's actually Swag, the only one defending here in the pit, which is a really good position, but he has to do better than he's been doing all game.
Yeah, and if he's going to pick a time to step it up, what better time than do it now? Think he can do it?
Yeah, I think he can, but it is a lot of pressure to put on one person here. The rest are all stacked up in B. iBUYPOWER taking a huge gamble doing this, and unfortunately, the gamble is not going to pay off here. Titan choose the correct bomb site. The bomb is definitely going to go down here. Swag looking for the headshot, trying to get it. Existence is down, and there's Kenny. Instant return, and the bomb is down, and Kyanite, I don't see this happening. This retake 3-on-3 without a kit and with only one shotgun.
Well, Steel, 5-7, Days, CZ-75. Who knows, Skadoodle with a Nova, but Kenny S, he's good, he's very good. He gets one, Scream gets the other, and Kenny S, well, says, bye-bye, iBUYPOWER.
Yeah, there it is, 2-0 victory for...